Hello and welcome. In this video, I'll share some tips for using DevTunnels, a new Microsoft service for developers. My name is Jason Gingero, and I'm a software engineer for DevTunnels. In case you're not yet familiar with DevTunnels, I'll give you a quick description here, but I recommend you first watch the video from my colleagues, Carolina and Jake, for a broader overview. DevTunnels is a service that allows you to securely expose your local endpoint to the internet for testing and debugging web apps, web APIs, and webhooks. It makes it easy to test on other devices, test integration with cloud services, or share work in progress with others while still running your code locally. When you create a DevTunnel, your local application gets a unique DNS name that browsers or other clients can connect to. In this video, I'm going to focus on the cross-platform DevTunnel command line tool, though most of the same functionality is available in the latest version of Visual Studio. Whenever you expose a service in development to the internet, you should be thoughtful about security. You might be working on an internal or confidential project, working with sensitive data, or just reasonably cautious about an application that hasn't yet been thoroughly reviewed and hardened against potential abuse. For these reasons, DevTunnels is designed to be secure by default. That means connections to a tunnel are encrypted and authenticated, and only you can connect to a DevTunnel that you created. DevTunnels apply that additional layer of security even if the application you're sharing does not use any encryption or authentication. If that default security doesn't work for your scenario, I'll explain a few options for authentication and access control for DevTunnels. These include different ways of logging in, allowing other people in your organization to connect to a tunnel, configuring support for an application that has integrated authentication, authenticating clients with an access token instead of a browser login flow, or pre-authenticating a connection on a device so that other clients on that device can reuse the connection without explicit credentials. Before creating a tunnel with a DevTunnel command line tool, you need to log in. A few different login methods are supported. You can log in with a Microsoft account, such as an Azure Active Directory account for your work or school or a personal Microsoft account, or you can log in with GitHub. For either Microsoft or GitHub, you can use the dash D option to use a device code flow. So instead of launching your browser directly, it will provide a short code that you can use to log in from another device. For unattended scripting or automation scenarios, it's also possible to log in with an AAD service principal identity and a client certificate. Visual Studio also allows selecting the account to use for DevTunnels in case you've signed in with multiple accounts. The choice of account here might be relevant later because clients will also need to authenticate with the same account that you use to connect to the tunnel, unless you change the default tunnel access control. If you want to allow others to connect to a tunnel, a simple but insecure solution is to allow anonymous client access. But a more secure option could be to grant access to your organization. So if you log in with an AAD account, you can grant access to everyone in your AAD tenant. Or if you log in with GitHub, you can grant access to a GitHub org that you're a member of. When a client tries to connect, they'll be redirected to the AAD or GitHub authentication flow and then allowed to access the tunnel only if they're a member of that organization. If the application already has integrated authentication, then you might not need that additional layer of access control. In that case, you can configure the tunnel to allow anonymous connections. Then the application can be in full control of the client authentication and login flow as needed. Depending on the type of login performed by the application, two additional configuration steps might be necessary. I'll demonstrate setting up a tunnel to connect to an application with AAD authentication, and I'll explain those configuration steps. For this demo, I'm going to create and run the web app in a remote dev box. Then I'll use a tunnel to connect to the web app from a browser on the local PC that I'm presenting from. First, I'll use the .NET new command to create a new ASP.NET web app using a template that includes AAD authentication. Then the MS Identity App Sync tool registers an AAD app ID and configures it in the project app settings. Now I can run the application with .NET run. And let's just check if the login is working on the device. So it's prompting me for permission and then logging me in. And you can see I'm signed in with my Microsoft.com account. So that works here in the dev box on the localhost there, but I want to connect to this application through a dev tunnel from the PC that I'm presenting from. So I can go back to another window and create a dev tunnel. And add the port number that was used there, so it's port 7042. Which is HTTPS. And since this application already has integrated authentication, I'm going to allow anonymous access to the tunnel so that it'll be up to the application to authenticate. And I'll start the tunnel with the devtunnel host command. Now I can take this unique URL that is given me for the tunnel and go to my client PC and I see this anti-phishing page, which is just a warning for anybody connecting to a tunnel that they're not connecting to a production site. It's trying to log me in with Microsoft account, but there's an error, which is actually expected in this case, because I haven't finished the configuration. You can see here that it redirected after logging in to localhost, but this localhost is on this client PC. It's not on the dev box. So there's a problem with the redirection. The way login redirection works is using the HTTP host header. So there's an option on a dev tunnel to change how the HTTP host header is handled. Normally, the dev tunnel relay will rewrite the HTTP host header to be localhost because that works better for most applications. But for auth redirection, we need to change that option so that it will preserve the tunnel DNS name. So dev tunnel update host header unchanged tells the tunnel relay to not change the host header so that the application will then redirect to the tunnel. So if I go back to that tunnel URL, now we got a different error. So it says this redirect URI is not valid because it's not configured in the application. Well, the URI looks correct in that it is the tunnel URI, but it's right that we didn't configure that as a valid redirect URI in the application. So we'll have to go to the Azure portal where that app ID was registered. And And here's the tunnel demo that was automatically created by that MS Identity tool. And we can go to the redirect URI settings and copy and paste this redirect URI here. And save changes. Now, if I try again, and now you see I'm signed in to the application, connecting from my client PC through the tunnel. In the previous demo and slides, I showed an interactive browser login, but for web API clients, it can be more convenient to connect and authenticate with a tunnel access token. So when creating a tunnel, you can use the devtunnel token command to get an access token, and then copy and paste that into the input of a command line tool such as curl, or a web API testing tool such as Postman. The header name xtunnel authorization is different from the standard authorization header to avoid potential conflicts with any application auth. So in this next demo, I'll set up a simple web API project with a tunnel and use a tunnel access token to make API requests. So I'll again use .NET new to create a web API project. This time I won't have any integrated authentication for the API. And I'll build and run the application. And let's quickly check that it's working. So this template gives us a weather forecast API. So we can see the JSON response there. Now I'll set up a tunnel for that web API. It was port 5150. So now the tunnel is running, and this time I want to use an API testing tool to connect from my client PC. So I have Thunder Client, which is a VS Code extension that allows us to test web APIs. I'll paste in the tunnel URL with weather forecast endpoint. And you see here we got a 302 status response. And what's happening is the tunnel relay is trying to redirect to authentication because we didn't supply any credentials in the request. So if I go back here, I can use the devtunnel token command to get an access token. Now I can copy that and paste into a request header, that xtunnel authorization header name. Try sending the request again. And this time we got a 200 OK with the JSON response. Instead of having each client authenticate tunnel connections with a login or an access token, it's possible to forward tunnel ports to a client's localhost. The devtunnel connect command is essentially the inverse of the devtunnel host command. The connect command establishes a secure authenticated connection to the tunnel relay. And then client apps can connect to forwarded ports from that tunnel on their local host. And then those connections will be forwarded to the same port on the tunnel host. So now I'll continue from the previous demo and use the devtunnel CLI to log in and connect to the tunnel instead of using the separate access token authentication. So for this, I'm going to open a command prompt on my client PC where I'm already logged in with the same user account, and then I can use the devtunnel connect command. And now this is connected, and you can see it is forwarding port 5150 to the client's localhost. So now if I go back to the VS Code Thunder client, I can change this to localhost 5150. And since the connection is already authenticated, I don't need this token anymore. And I can send the request, and I still get that JSON response. In summary, DevTunnels offer several authentication and access control capabilities to help you stay secure while developing and testing your web applications and web APIs. I hope these explanations help you use DevTunnels in more ways to accelerate your productivity. For more information on these topics, check out the reference links in the video description. Thank you for watching.